Bud.
Beatty, please.
Oh, Bud, I'm afraid. Oh, Bud. Don't, Bud.
Beatty.
No, we mustn't, Bud.
Splendor in the Grass is a 1961 period drama film that would find box office success and help launch the careers of some memorable Hollywood stars. Taking place in 1928 Kansas, the story revolves around two high school teenagers, Wilma Dean, Deanie Loomis, played by Natalie Wood, and her boyfriend Bud Stamper, played by Warren Beatty. Both of them badly crave a more heated sexual relationship, but they avoid it at the advice of their parents. Deanie's parents, including her mother, Mrs. Loomis, played by Audrey Christie, tell Deanie that sex with her boyfriend would destroy her reputation.
Wilma Dean, you and Bud haven't gone too far already, have you?
No, Mother.
Tell me the truth, Wilma Dean.
No, Mom, we haven't gone too far.
In the meantime, Bud's wealthy oil tycoon father, Ace Stamper, played by Pat Hingle, has big plans for his football-playing son, Bud. This is even more the case after Bud's sister, Ginny, played by Barbara Loden, a flapper, returns from Chicago after an annulled marriage and rumors of an abortion.
I hate it here. I'm a freak in this town. Everybody stares at me on the street like I was something out of a carnival.
That's because you peroxide your hair and paint your face up like an Indian.
Morning, everybody.
Hey, how are you?
Just great. Huh? He's going to make me stay home a whole year just to punish me.
There aren't any more schools left that'll have you.
No, Ginny. There's nothing so distasteful
about
being a
cold. This is the ugliest place in the whole world. What? Everywhere you look, there's an oil well, even on the front lawn. I'll bet you drill for a well right here in the dining room.
You damn right I would if I thought there's any oil in there.
Bud becomes more and more sexually frustrated and begins to attract the attention of a red-headed girl with a more promiscuous reputation named Juanita, played by Jan Norris. Bud and Deanie try hard to control their sexual urges.
My feet, slave.
But don't.
Now tell me you love me.
But you're hurting
me. Tell me you
me.
Can't live without me.
But I...
Say it.
I do.
You do what?
I do love
and
you.
And you can't live without me.
And
you'll be everything I ever ask you to be. Anything.
I'd do anything for you.
Deanie, I didn't mean to hurt you.
I can't kid about these things. Because I am nuts about you. And I would go down on my knees to worship you if you really wanted me to. And I would do anything you'd ask me to. I would. Oh, Bud. Bud. Bud.
Bud decides that he should perhaps pass on going to Yale and marry Deanie. His father tries to persuade him to wait, and that perhaps he needs to find a more promiscuous girl to unleash the sexual urges of his loins.
Two kinds of girls, and us boys, we'd never even mention them in the same breath, but every now and then, one of us boys would sneak off with a girl, and we'd get a little steam out of our sister.
No girl looks good to me except Deanie.
Oh, I know so. Hello.
With the country in the midst of a massive economic boom, with Deanie's parents investing in stocks and Bud's parents enshrined in wealth, they all welcome the year 1929. Ginny acts like a whore, much to the chagrin of Mr. Stamper, leading to Bud getting in a fist fight with several men who attempt to have their way with Ginny inside of a car. After Bud collapses with exhaustion and comes down with pneumonia, he decides to end his relationship with Deanie and have a sexual fling with Juanita. Deanie falls into depression and despair, shocking her parents.
Did he spoil you?
Spoil? Did he spoil me? No! No, Mom! I'm not spoiled, Mom! I'm just as fresh and I'm virginal like the day I was born, Mom!
Stop it! Stop it!
A lovely virginal creature! What do you think of me?
Stop it, darling! Stop it!
A guiltless girl!
She then winds up being institutionalized just as the stock market crash of 1929 hits the country, affecting all of the characters throughout the film in different ways. This film was written by William Ng, who based some of the characters off of people he knew growing up in rural Kansas in the 1920s. He told the story to director Elia Kazan, and they decided to make it into a film. Ng wrote it first as a novel and then as a screenplay. Despite taking place in Kansas and some scenes in New Haven, Connecticut, a severe drought forced the production to relocate all shooting to New York State. The movie was filmed between May and August 1960 in Staten Island, New York, as well as the Bronx and High Falls. Jody McCrae, Troy Donahue, and Dennis Hopper were all considered for the role of Bud Stamper. Diane Varsi and Lee Remick were considered for the role of Deanie. This movie marked the film debut of many actors: Warren Beatty, Sandy Dennis, Marla Adams, Eugene Roche, and Phyllis Diller all had their first appearances in this movie. Jane Fonda wrote in her autobiography that she tested for the role of Deanie. When Elia Kazan asked her if she was ambitious, she said no, even though she was, because she thought good girls aren't supposed to be ambitious. Jane Fonda claims that this might have been the reason that she didn't get the role. Even though they were supposed to be playing teenagers, Natalie Wood and Warren Beatty were 22 and 23 years old respectively during filming. As a result, Elia Kazan decided that the other actors who were to play teenagers in the film should be in their early to mid-20s as a way to make it easier for the audience to accept Wood and Beatty as teenagers. Pat Hingle, who plays Warren Beatty's father, was only 13 years older than Warren Beatty. According to one of the makeup artists, the crew found Warren Beatty arrogant and didn't like him. In fact, he was given the nickname Mental Anguish, or M.A. for short, that crew members called him behind his back. Right before shooting began, Pat Hingle suffered devastating injuries when he accidentally fell 54 feet down an elevator shaft in his apartment building. It would take Hingle over a year to fully recover from the fall. In the meantime, however, he decided to go ahead and do the movie, and he simply incorporated his limp into the character. Elia Kazan did whatever was necessary to bring out the best possible performances by his actors, and it was one of the reasons he was known as one of the best directors in the business. From the beginning, he wanted to strip away the Hollywood glamour from Natalie Wood and get her to a more natural state for the camera, which would be more appropriate for the character of Deanie. According to her friend Mark Crawley, Natalie Wood was always looking to sneak on a little extra lipstick when Kazan wasn't looking. As originally filmed, in the sequence in which Deanie takes a bath while arguing with her mother, the bickering becomes so intense that Wilma jumps out of the tub and runs down a hallway to her bedroom, nude, where the camera cuts to a close-up of her bare legs kicking hysterically on the mattress. Both the Hollywood censors and the Catholic Legion of Decency objected to the hallway scene, finding the bare backside of Natalie Wood unsuitable for public display. In an early 1970s TV interview with Mike Douglas, Natalie Wood claimed that the European cut of the film she eventually saw in France left in the nudity in the hallway. However, no versions of this movie exist that show the nudity from Natalie Wood. Elia Kazan and Barbara Loden were a couple during filming. They had begun an affair several years earlier and had to keep it under wraps since Kazan was married at the time. This movie does appear to contain the first French kiss ever seen in a Hollywood film. It occurs between Warren Beatty and Jan Norris, the redhead, during the waterfall scene. Released into theaters October 10, 1961, Splendor in the Grass grossed over $8 million, becoming a large box office success. It would go on to be nominated at the Academy Awards for Best Story and Screenplay, and Natalie Wood was nominated for Best Actress. Many actors and actresses hold this film in very high acclaim. Reese Witherspoon, Leslie Ann Warren, and Bill Paxton all stated that Splendor in the Grass was their personal favorite film. This film would go on to spawn two songs, Jackie DeShannon's 1966 song Splendor in the Grass and the hit song Hey Deanie, written by Eric Carmen and performed by Sean Cassidy, which hit number 7 on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100 charts in January 1978. Some people have questioned what the point of this film was. I think that it was basically trying to tackle the issue of repressed sexual urges in teenagers. Basically, Bud had a really bad case of blue balls, but didn't want to hurt Deanie's reputation, and Deanie is hot and horny for Bud but can't act on it, so they're both losing their minds. Makes perfect sense to me. This is a very well-made movie, and I also like the fact that it shows middle America during the very end of the Roaring Twenties. Many people forget that in 1928 America, the country was riding high on prosperity. President Calvin Coolidge, who declined running in 1928 after the death of his son, was extremely popular, and despite Herbert Hoover's name being synonymous with the Great Depression and unpopularity, many people often forget that in 1928, Herbert Hoover was a landslide president. He was extremely popular up until 11 months later with the crash of 1929. I like this movie a lot. I watch it from time to time and I think it's very well made. The actors are wonderful. Natalie Wood was beautiful. And I have to say that Pat Hingle really steals the show as Ace Stamper. I highly recommend the 1961 period drama, Splendor in the Grass.